Let's consider now another example of entangled and separable states. We now consider three qubits, A, B, and C, or if you want, Alice, Bob, and Charlie, which are in some global state psi ABC. Let's imagine that the global state is in fact in this particular state, which is also called the Jude set state. We will now have a look at different parts of the state. And the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to look at what does the reduced state on just row AB look like. So we're going to have a look at just the two qubits row AB, and we're going to ask, is row AB entangled? So row AB is the reduced state. I trace out C. From the state on ABC. So if we do this calculation, what we find is that this state is given by 0, 0 on A, tensor 0, 0 on B, plus half times 1, on A, tensor 1, on B. With a C that if I trace out C, the state on AB is separable between A and B. Let's now have a look at the other qubit. Let's imagine now that I bunch B and C together and I'm asking, are B and C together entangled with A? And the answer to this question is yes. And we can easily see this by noting that if I bunch B and C together, then the state is very similar than the EPR pair. If I have 0 on A, I have, say, also 0 together on B and C. And if I have 1 on A, I have 1 on B and C. In fact, we can see that we could easily produce the Jude set state on A, B, C if I'm fixing the qubit A, I have the qubit B, and I attach an ancilla C to B, and if I start with the EPR pair between A and B, I can apply a C-node operation, a unitary, to B and C to obtain the Jude set state. So across A together with B and C, we are entangled. You have now seen a state of which parts of the state, depending on which qubits you look at, can be entangled or separable.